Hey guys, how's it going? Jesse here. So I know it's been yet another month since I made another video. I apologize for that. But the thing is that me and my family have been dealing with a lot of stuff personally. Mostly my mom, her cancer actually came back very recently, and she just went through her first session of chemotherapy again. She had lesions that came back, cancer lesions, but thankfully they weren't as big as the previous lesions, the ones that affected her in the past. So that's good news. And hopefully she'll end up being okay and the cancer will just fuck off like it did before and stay fucked off. That's the hope anyway. So yeah, that's something that we have been dealing with as a family. It's a lot. I'm going to be honest, earlier today I actually cried about it because she's my mom and I love her very much. Her and I have always been close, and seeing this lovely woman struggling the way that she does, it's terrible. It really is. It's always the best people, at least in my experience, who have to end up struggling the most, and it's unfair. You'd think it'd be the other way around, but no, I guess not. Life is a fucking bitch, ain't it? This is actually the fourth time my mom has had cancer in total. Well, you know what I mean. Like, this is the fourth time it came back, I guess. I mean, when she was first diagnosed, that was the first time, and then the cancer came back three other times. That's what I mean. Sorry for the confusion. And to make matters worse, me, my sister, my grandfather, and my mom, obviously, we have something called the BRCA gene, and that basically means that you're much more likely to get cancer. Now, it doesn't mean that you're necessarily going to get it. It just means that you're more likely to get it. And that is especially apparent with women, because women have breasts and uterus, ovaries, all that stuff that men don't have. Therefore, it increases the chances of them getting cancer. Obviously, men can still get it too. It's just less likely. The one person who actually doesn't have the gene is my brother, so I'm happy for him that he doesn't have it, but unfortunately the rest of us have it. It doesn't mean necessarily that I'm going to get cancer, or my sister, or even my grandfather, because my grandfather's 77 and he's been perfectly fine. I never talked about that before, the whole BRCA gene thing, but now you guys know. I'm choosing to share it with you. And the other thing that I wanted to talk about is my OCD. This is something that I didn't mention in my letting it all out video, and I wish I did, but it completely slipped my mind because I was so focused on all the other subjects that I was talking about in that particular video, and it's gotten really bad. It's gotten to the point where it's making me feel really suicidal. It's gotten to the point where I've developed tics, so every time I get a bad thought, I go like this, and I say, no, 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 I start saying things to myself. I sound like a fucking crazy person. So yeah, that's my way of basically coping with the thoughts. My brain, I've been doing it for so long that it's very hard to stop. And my brain is making me think that it's going to help with the thoughts, but it actually makes things worse. So yeah, go figure. OCD is actually something that runs in the family. My mom has it. My sister, actually, does my sister have it? I'm not entirely sure. Either way, my mom definitely has it. My brother definitely has it. My grandfather and myself, obviously. And depression also runs in our family. I just want to be honest with you guys and let you know why I haven't really been making videos lately. Life is very difficult. It's very hard. Obviously, there are people out there that have it a lot worse than, for example, I do, of course. I'm just saying that life for a lot of people, and life for this family, has not exactly been easy. That's pretty much all I wanted to say. For those of you who have stuck around all this time, I just want to thank you for staying subscribed, leaving positive feedback. Really appreciate it. I hope each and every one of you have a much better year, and I hope 2021 is a much better year. I hope, what am I trying to say? I'm sorry, I'm just blah, blah. I hope 2021 treats you better than 2020 did. That's what I'm trying to say. Each and every one of you. Because 2020 was awful. It was fucking shit. Thanks for watching, and I will see you guys in future videos. Obviously. Peace out.